When the Genesis Coupe debuted, it proved that Hyundai was serious about performance. And for its second act, the 2013 model adds more of what we both love, horsepower and style.
It doesn't seem like all that long ago when I was sitting in the all-new Genesis Coupe getting drifting lessons from Reese Millen. But now in its fourth model year and sporting a significant redesign, the new Genesis Coupe benefits from technology upgrades that allow the engines to deliver more while consuming less. More performance required the sport-tuned suspension to be recalibrated, delivering more precision yet improved ride comfort. Steering, a recent bugaboo of some Hyundai cars, feels more natural and quicker to respond. And my least favorite styling cue from the previous car, the small, awkward-looking grille, has been replaced with a more aggressive front fascia, with perhaps a bit of Mazda 3 inspiration. Still available in 4- and 6-cylinder variants, my tester is the Genesis Coupe 2.0T Premium with the optional automatic transmission. The 5-speed unit has been replaced with an 8-speed automatic. So while the turbo now generates a whopping 30% more horsepower, fuel economy actually improves by 1 mpg combined, rated at 20 city, 31 highway. Premium gas is recommended, but not required. Utilizing a new twin-scroll turbo and a larger intercooler, this Genesis Coupe now puts out 274 horsepower and 275 pound-feet of torque, blessing this car with a superior 12.3-to-1 power-to-weight ratio. Quick off the line with a 0-to-60 time of about 6 seconds, but even more fun wagging the tail and lighting up the tires. The Genesis Coupe does rear drive rascality as well or better than its American competitors. That's because this car is a lot lighter and shorter, giving it an unencumbered, sprightly nature that frankly makes it more fun to drive. There's a bit of turbo lag, but once you're off, the Genesis Coupe handles the road with a premium level of precision and grip. And it's definitely friendly enough to use every day. My only complaint about driver controls is that the manual action of the transmission is slow in making gear changes. Of course, real manual transmissions are offered on most models. Something borrowed from the Camaro that probably should have remained there are these three gauges on the center stack that are difficult for the driver to read while actually driving. Otherwise, the interior has been spruced up with softer touch materials, an electroluminescent gauge cluster, and better functionality for entering the rear seats, which are okay on legroom, but seriously lacking in headroom. The front seats are nicely bolstered and supportive. Concerning sound levels, you hear quite a bit of road noise from inside, but little in the way of engine and exhaust. For amenities, proximity key and push-button start are standard, as is everything else you see in this car, including BlueLink telematics, which is an OnStar-like service that also incorporates voice text messaging and POI downloads to your Navi system beyond its traditional connectivity functions. MSRP of this premium model is $29,625. The Genesis Coupe, a no-excuses car for performance enthusiasts, has the look and the variety of models to suit a wide range of tastes and budgets. For Drive Time on Yahoo Autos, I'm Steve Hammes.